Please subscribe to our channel and for latest update click on the bell icon.
Now we will look into ourselves and see how helpful am I? How to become a helpful child? How can you get parents, friends and teachers to say, wow, you are a helpful little girl, you are a helpful little boy. So we are cultivating a very good habit. What is that habit? I must help or I must be helpful. I must help. Help, that's a very good quality to cultivate, to develop. Helping a person is very good attitude. Regarding helping, you find the nature of helping among friends. Now, once there were two little friends. One was a lame person, another a blind person. Now, these two friends, they made their life living by begging. Now, they need to go from one place to another. The blind person need help. The lame person also need help. So what they decided, they will help each other in their livelihood. So what will the blind man friend do? The blind friend would carry the lame friend on his back, and the lame person would guide the way. And they will go from one place to another, stop at a place, beg, make their living. Now, everyone looked at these two and said, wow, how helpful they are, how supportive they are. The lame man and the blind man, both great friends, helping each other, making a living. In life, we too must learn to help. Now, the quality of help, helping, the nature of helping, we learn at home. First, we learn to help our mommy, our daddy at home in small errands, in keeping things nicely, fetching things for mother, getting something for daddy. Learning to help, first we cultivate, develop in our own home. Mommy says, I can't find my keys. You run, look for it, and you help mommy with the keys. Now, helping, we continue into our school. We learn to help our friends, we learn to help our classmates, we learn to help our teacher, and so on. Helping each other. Helping, when you learn something when you're mastered, you also learn to give that skill what you acquire to support your friend. Now, just like the lame and the blind, the two friends, how they supported each other, we too should support each other when learning takes place in the school. A lot of activities that goes on where we must help. So, I must help. I'm sure you learned a lot of songs helping. Okay? Now, I'll tell you a little song we learned. Helping. Okay? Helping hand. How many hands do you have? You have two hands. And what do you do with your two hands? You help. First, doing work, you help yourself, you help your parents, you help your help yourself to do your work, you help your teachers, etc. So let's sing a song, Helping Hand. Listen carefully, okay? Helping hand, helping one another, I'll do all I can. With my helping hand, oh, I'll do all I can. With my helping hand, When I see someone fall down, I will lift him up. If they are lying on the ground, I use my helping hand. Helping hand, helping one another, I'll do all I can. With my helping hands, oh, I'll do all I can. With my helping hand, when my mommy is a cook and the baby's crying, I'll read to him a book and use my helping hands. Helping hand, helping one another, I'll do all I can. With my helping hand, oh, I'll do all I can. With my helping hand, your hands are there to help yourself, to help your friends. So let us use our hands for helping. I must help. Who do you help at home? Your parents. I must help my parents at home. My parents at home. In what? In doing small errands, fetching things, fixing things, cleaning house, whatever. So, I must help my parents at home. We learn the first value of helping at home. And it is mommy who will teach us, daddy who will teach us that we need to be helpful, that we must help others. So, first lesson is learn at home. So, I must help my parents at home in some small work. What are the work you can do at home? Help mommy by keeping your toys, your book study table neatly, your plate neatly, your shoes in the proper place, your bags in the proper place, keeping your bedroom nicely. You are helping mommy and daddy. You're reducing their work. You're also being a useful, helpful child at home. All right, next. I must help. You have a small brother, a big brother, small sister, a big sister at home. So, you need to help mommy in supporting. So, I must help my brother, sister, big or small. I must help my brother or sister, big or small, at home. Mommy is busy, so you need to give us helping hand. You need to help your little brother, little sister in supporting mommy, and then you can get help from your big sister, you can get help from your big brother. So, I must help. Helping, learning the first value at home. I must help who else? I must help my grandparents at home. My grandparents at home. So, if you have an extended family, your grandparents are staying at home, then you must help them. What do they need? What kind of help the grandparents need? They need to be listened to. They need to fetch some water or to take them somewhere, get their needs, their slippers or anything, something what they like, a paper to read, a book to read, some whatever little help the grandparents asking, keeping them happy is your happiness too. So, you are being a helpful child. Your grandparents, wow, what a nice little girl or boy. They're helping me to be happy. Then, I must help. Other than grandparents, there'll be elders at home. I must help my elders at home. When you talk about elders, we talk about aunts and uncles, or other people who come home, dads and mums, friends who come home, any elder, anybody older than you, you need to help. Can I help you? Can I do something for you? Can I fetch this for you? Helping, always being a available, helping. That's a very good habit. Next, I must help the teachers at school. The teacher will need some help. Find out, what does she need? To fetch something? Help her out. So, I must help the teachers. The teachers at school. Helping. We need to get a good name from the teacher, from parents. Helpful, ready to do something. Should be a girl or a boy ready to do alertness all the time. Who wants my help? Maybe my friend, my teacher, my mommy, my brother, grandparents, elders. Eagerness, being ready to help. That's a very good attitude to cultivate. I must help my friends at school and the neighborhood. You have a lot of friends at home and in the neighborhood. So, I must help my friends at school, then and in the neighborhood, all your friends. Helping. What do you do? How do you help your friends at school? Maybe some work that you're doing, some project that you're doing, helping to complete the notes, helping to complete the homework, whatever. In the neighborhood, discussing something, getting something done, maybe festival time, any kind of help. Helping in the neighborhood. Okay. Next, I must help the poor and the needy. I must help the poor people, the poor and the needy. Who wants my help? Who needs my help? What kind of help? So, in all this, what are you trying to cultivate? I'm trying to cultivate being a available, a helpful child. I must help my parents at home in small errands. I must help my brothers and sisters at home. I must help my grandparents at home. I must help the elders at home, my aunts and uncles. I must help the teachers at home, at school. The teacher will want some help to be done. You will help. I must help my friends at school and my friends in the neighborhood. I must help the poor and the needy who needs my help. Remember, helping hand. We have hands and those are for helping. Remember, always the lame and the blind, the two friends who supported each other. Helping each other to live a decent life. Now, let's look at some of the sounds that has gone into this. I sound is E, M, ha sound. M, P, A, ha sound. M, B, and S, A, and ha sound again. M, G, P, A, ha. M, E, A, ha, a sound, a sound. Then you have T, again T sound, a, s sound. Then you have M, sound, a, and s, e, n sound. T, p, a, t, and n sound. Now, let's read together. What are we trying to learn now? We are learning to be a helpful person, ready to help anyone at any time. I must help my parents at home. I learned the value of helping at home first. I must help my brothers and sisters, elder brother, younger brother, elder sister, younger sister. I must help. I must help my grandparents at home. I must help the elders at home, like my aunts and uncles or anybody else, older people who come home. I must help my teachers at school. I must help my friends at school. I must help my friends in the neighborhood. And I must help the poor and the needy. What are we learning from all this? We are learning to be helpful, ready, always ready to use our helping hands. The good quality of helping, using your helping hand all the time. I must help. Who else will you help? I must help all those who come home. People come home, or friends will come asking for help. I must help those who come home for help. Sometimes people come home asking for help. Friends will come home to work together, some help. So I must help those who come home asking for help. Then I must help when someone is in danger. I must use my helping hand. I must help when someone is in danger, is in danger. You have found somebody, some child, someone in danger, you must go, give your helping hand. See what you can do. See who you can get there to help that person. I must help when someone is sick at home, when mommy not well, your sister is not well, your baby brother not well, you must give a helping hand to mama. So I must help when someone, is sick at home, It can be your grandparents or uncles or someone in the house need some help, not feeling too good, so you need to lend your helping hand. Then I must help anyone who gets hurt. You find maybe at home or at school somebody gets hurt, so I must help anyone who gets hurt. You must know what to do. Who gets hurt when you run in the games field, run up the stairs and down the stairs, you can fall, you can get hurt. How do you do? What do you do? Who do you go to help? So be aware, be alert to help someone at home or at school who gets hurt while moving around. Then I must help someone with my money, food or clothes, maybe at home or at school, somewhere. I must help. With what will you help? With my pocket money. Make it useful. I must help someone. I must help with my pocket money or the food I have. Little bit. Somebody wouldn't bring food, you can share. You can also help the clothes that you do not want, the toys that you do not need. Giving, helping someone who needs that. Somebody needs a small helping hand. Some child forget to bring. Say, I will share a little bit of food with her. So, helping, I must help with my pocket money or food or toys or books, something that I do not want, that somebody needs, I must lend a helping hand. Give my books, story books to somebody who needs. Then I must help to keep me, I am helping. Okay? I must help mommy in keeping my study table neat. You're helping yourself, you're also helping mommy. I must help myself. You're helping yourself. I must help myself to keep my study room neat and tidy. You are not giving mommy work, you are helping yourself. So I must help myself. Helping yourself to be a helpful person, how? To keep my study room neat and clean. So that's a very good thing for mommy. Then I must help others. For what? To keep me happy. You're doing it willingly. Any help that you're rendering others, you're doing it willingly. So I must help to keep myself happy. Why do you help? To keep myself happy. You want to be a happy child. You want to be a happy person. So I'm a helpful person. Then I must help. I help because I want to get a good name. I must help to get a good name. When you are small, you want a good name. So you help so that you want a good name. Mommy says, oh, you're very good. You did that. You got a good name from mommy. Then you also need to help those who work at home, those who help mommy. I must help those who work at home. People who work at home helping mom and dad, you must help them also in their need. What are we learning from here? You are learning to cultivate the good habit of helping. Our hand should be used for helping. And where do we learn the first lesson? At home. Mom and dad will help us. Big brother, sister, grandparents, uncles and aunts. All these people will help us to be helpful. We help them and they help us. So we learn the habit of helping at home. And here let's see. I must help who? Those who come home asking for some help. I must help when someone is in danger, somebody is in trouble. See what you can do. See you who you can call up. I must help when someone is sick at home. Mommy needs a helping hand. I must help anyone who gets hurt in the game field or anywhere. I must help with my small pocket money, my food, my clothes, my toys in a small manner. I cultivate the habit of helpfulness. I must help myself to keep my study room, my personal things properly. Thus, I am helping my mommy. I must help. I must help. Why I help? To keep myself happy. When I am happy, I feel helpful. I can be helpful to others. I must help to get a good name. When I am small, when I am cultivating the habit of helpfulness, I need to get a good name. And then finally, helpfulness becomes part of me. Finally, I must help those who work at home, those who are helping mommy and daddy at home. I must help them too. Find out what are they need, where do they need the help. Let us look at some of the sounds that has come up. Okay, you have T sound, wa sound, K, ha. Wa, s, e again, d. Wa, s, e, s, a, and ha sound, a. Wa, g, ha. Wa, n, p, n, sound, k, t, and b. Then you have t, k, m, r, n, t, k, m, ha, t, g, a, g, n, t, wa. wa, ha, and ha. Let's look at this and read it together. What are we trying to learn? We're trying to learn to be a helpful child, helpful, happy child. I must help those who come home asking for help. I must help when someone is in danger, in trouble. I must be alert. Who I can call? What can I do? I must help when someone is sick at home or someone is sick at school, in the class. How can I help? What can I do? Who do I ask help? I must help anyone who gets hurt in the games field at home. How to go about helping? What medicine to put? I must be alert. I must help with the little pocket money that I have. Someone who needs it. Food. A friend of mine didn't bring some food. I share my food. My clothes and toys and books which I do not need. I help by giving to someone who needs it. Then, why do I spend my pocket money, toys, books? Why do I want to cultivate to be a helpful child? I help so that I can keep myself happy. Then I must help to keep my, I help myself to keep my study room clean. When I keep the study room clean, I am helping mommy and I am also helping myself. Why am I being helpful? I am cultivating helpfulness to keep myself also happy, to make this part of me. I must help to get a good name. I help all those who work for mom and dad at home. Doing this and cultivating the habit of helpfulness, helping hand to those who need.